Oh. Thank you. celebrate the sacred mysteries, let each one of us recall in mind our own personal sins. One, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
May God's strong love, together with John Paul, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember Della Carmina, whom you called to this life. In baptism, she died with Christ. May she also share his resurrection.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
This is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his supper. Thank you. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go on your knees to serve the Lord.
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And beloved, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Beloved George, we may I thank all of you for joining the people of Little Flower this morning, especially the members and clergy of other faiths. Greetings also to the mayor of Hollywood, members of the City Commission, and of course the Hollywood Historical Society. And also we welcome very specially Father Frank Dunleavy, one of the former pastors of the parish. We're honored to have with us today Mrs. Suzanne Gunsberger of the Bard County Commission. We give special thanks to all who work so hard to organize for this day.
On behalf of the all our people to welcome Mayor Mara here this morning and the members of the City Commission, and Mr. Sam Finns, the City Manager. Also here with us this morning is Mickey Kavanaugh, who works so hard on all of this, Chris DeLuca, and Maury Connell also, and all of you. And I know I'm omitting people now. The great people who 70 years ago had the faith and the vision. People like Father Frank Dunleavy, who was here with us today, to build a community like this, to sustain it. And we talked over in the rectory area about the generosity of those people and the hard work and the courage of those people. Many of them are not with us today, but they're with the one God that made us all.
Of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father.
much I've enjoyed sharing with you the joy of this very special recognition that has been given to your very special church and to this historic site. I'm sure the distinction which has come to this sacred center of your religious lives is highly gratifying to all of you, and we are very grateful to those who made it possible. I pray that this new distinction that has come to this physical building, these buildings built of stone, will be a stimulus and encouragement for an even greater enhancement of the spiritual church of living stones. You are the faithful of whom Jesus Christ himself is the very cornerstone. Here may your religious life become now even more resplendent as you continue to grow in holiness, grow in the love of God and the love of each other, in the splendor of your faith, in the gracefulness of your prayers, even more elegant than your physical church building. May the way you live and proclaim the gospel be the way you reflect here the radiant beauty of the Lord himself. I say to the all-loving God, bless all of you abundantly. God bless you.
I know that the warmth that we feel today is even more than the heat that we feel from the sun. We're blessed that this is a beautiful weekend. I want to tell you what a pleasure it is once again to be here. Last time I did mention when I was with you all that although we may do a plaque and although it's placed on a building, it's really just our way of showing in a tangible way that we recognize all the wonderful people that have been a part of this parish. Many of you who are here remember the past, far greater, of course, than I do, or even Commissioner Anderson might. So today, when we unveil the plaque, let's all remember and honor the memory of those who made St. Teresa, Church of the Little Flower, as special as it is in our community, as it was, and let us all rejoice, as Commissioner Gunsberger said, in what I believe will be a glorious future. Congratulations, and thank you for allowing me to be a part of it. Now
we come to the plaque.
Says the Hollywood Historical Society Incorporated recognizes the Church of the Little Flower, the Rectory, and Church School as an historical landmark in the city of Hollywood, Florida, for their many years of important work of community development, unveiled October 22, 1994, by Mayor Mara Galante with Father Thomas O'Dwyer, pastor, and the Most Reverend Edward A. McCarthy, Archbishop of the Archdiocese of Miami, Patrick C. Cother, President, the Hollywood Historical Society Incorporated.
To you, St. Teresa, we pray on this day and ask your sweet blessings forever each day. So hear us, your children, invoking your sweet name. Oh, St. Teresa, St. Teresa, pray for us. God bless little flower, so dear to our hearts, our pride. Jesus.